Let's start with understanding how to remove any values using any.rm. So I am again using the same vectors that we have created earlier. Let's execute and create them. So in our vector 3, if I print it, you will see there are 3 missing numbers or any values present in this vector. Now, let's suppose I want to calculate mean of this value. So I'll say mean of V3. So it will provide me an output as NA because there are NA values present in this vector. If there is even one NA, even one missing value, it will respond, it will not calculate your mean value and will respond in NA. Wherein, if I use V1 vector, which has all the complete numbers, and I calculate mean, in this case, my mean will be calculated easily. Now, if I want to calculate mean for this vector 3, what I will do is, I'll say, so if you want to calculate mean value for vector containing missing values, we will say mean, we'll open the bracket, and I'll provide the name of the vector that I want to use mean for, then I'll put a comma and I'll say na.rm equal to true. And I'll execute it, and if you see, it has given me for all the numbers that are complete. No, like what is the mean value have, how this mean value have been created? 10, 20, and 50 calculated its mean. Let's see if it is correct or not. So 10, if I say 10 plus 20 plus 50 divided by 3. So the answer is same. So it will remove all the NA values and it will for remaining complete numbers. So this is how you can remove. You can use it for any arithmetic function you want. Let's say I want to sum up the V4 vector. So I'll say V4. I'll say NA.rm equal to true. And I'll run it. And you can perform this function. You can use na.rm with any of the arithmetic mean you want. Let's say I want to sum V3 vector. I'll say na.rm equal to true. So it will remove all the true, all the NA values, and will provide me some of the remaining numbers. So it will add up 50 plus 20 plus 10, which will give me 80 as the answer. Now the next way we have understood was by data filling or data imputation. So first let's understand data filling. So when I say data filling, what I am doing is I am filling all the NA numbers, all the missing values with a fixed number. Let's create a vector 4. In which I have given 1 to 10 as the first 10 numbers, then I'm repeating NA 5 times, and then there will be again numbers from 20 to 25. Let's see the output of this vector. So if you can see here, let's understand how to identify the NA numbers. So you will say is.NA. Then you can say vector 4. So it will give you all those numbers, all the values as true where there is NA. To sum up this, so you can say sum. So it will give you the count of total NA values in the vector. So you can see there are 5. Do is I want to fill all these NA with a, let's say, a specific number, a fixed number, let's say 50. So how can we do this? So what we will do, we will use our subsetting function, square bracket notation. So we will say first will be the vector name, so it is V4. In this vector, wherever, so I'll start with a square bracket. I'll say wherever there is NA values. So I'll use is.NA to identify all the NA values in the vector V4, and I will put an equal to after it, and I will say a fixed number, let's say 50, and I'll enter. So what it will do is all those values, all these numbers where there is NA, it will be replaced with 50. Let's see if it happened or not. So I'll print V4 again, and you can see we have changed all the numbers with 50 here. So this is how you can replace or you can fill the NA numbers with a fixed number. Now let's understand how to impute or you can replace a number with a reasonable value. Let's say we want to impute all NA numbers, NA values with the mean of that vector. So let's take an example of V3 again, where there is 10, then there is NA value, then 20, 50 and NA. So what we will do actually, we will say same way, the way we used square bracket notations here, same way we will be replacing all the numbers with the mean value of this vector. So first let's print mean of this vector. So I'll say mean. I'll say vector name. So my vector name is V3. I'll say na.rm equal to true. And I'll execute it. So my mean is 26.667. So my all NA numbers, all these when I input it. So how to do this? I'll say V3, I'll open square bracket notations and again identify all the NA values. So you will say is.NA V3. Wherever there is NA value in this vector, put equal to, and you just equate these two things here. So you will say mean, calculate mean of this vector by removing all the NA values. So it will, what, let's print V3 again, and if you see it, it will change all the NA values with the mean number. Similarly, want to show it with another number, let's see. Let's use another arithmetic function instead of mean. Let's try to change all the numbers. Let's impute with it with a minimum number. So I'll say is.na vector 3 equal to min. So min is the function for minimum. I'll say V3 na dot rm equal to true. And let's execute it and print the vector V3. So you will see the values, they remain same because we didn't change the vector again. We have already imputed values here. That's why there was no NA, so it didn't work. So what we will do first, let's again print this vector. Now let's calculate minimum of it. So you can see the minimum value is 10. Now we will replace the minimum value of this vector with all the NAs. So I'll say V3 is dot NA, wherever the NA value is in this vector, it will be replaced with minimum NA values. Let's see. So minimum value.